Good morning from New York City and good evening in the East. I am so excited today to be speaking with Xu Zi Wei, but we're going to go by Mr. Wei. And we have once again Chu Chen, our amazing, amazing interpreter. Good morning from New York, Mr. Wei. You are an accomplished pop musician, songwriter, singer, and music producer. I want to know when you knew that you were just going to be a part of the music industry no matter what.
徐子崴先生来自纽约的问候，他非常荣幸今天能够采访您。您是中国的一位很有名的歌唱家，还有制作人。他想很好奇的就是，你是什么时候发现了自己音乐才能，然后决定了以此为一生的事业？我也很荣幸能够接受威尔导演的采访，我们跨越重洋的一个交流。我是在很小的时候。 我的爸爸就发现了我比较有音乐的这个爱好与特长，因为很小的时候就看电视啊、听广播啊，看到了一些音乐的表演或者听到一些音乐歌曲，然后我就很兴奋，而且呢，不需要别人教我，那我自己就会跟着去学唱啊，去哼唱。 而且特别喜欢表演，比如家里来了客人啊，来了朋友，然后很多人知道，哎，说这个小朋友很喜欢唱歌，你给我们唱一首吧，然后呢，我就会很自然的、很快乐的唱给大家。So
his musical talent started when he was very young. When he listened to radios, TVs, he can simply just hum them out, and he became to be interested. His father, he said, is in fact the jam polisher for him.
That's amazing. That's amazing. Well, I want to know also, you know, you've traveled so far and wide and have performed everywhere. And I'm curious to know if there's a particular performance that really stands out for you.
他想知道，在过去的这么多表演旅行的经验当中，因为您被常常受邀去其他的地方进行表演，有没有这样的一次是让您记忆犹新的？印象深刻，其实一定是参加我们中国的这个春节联欢晚会。是哪一年？我第一次登上春晚的舞台是2009年。 正好是一个轮回，上一个牛年。那是我第一次，对，第二次是2011年，然后第三次是2020年。然后第三次是2020年，但是在这个过程当中，除了我自己登台演唱这三次之外，我还有十多首的我创作的作品，登上了这个春节晚会的舞台。
It's a great question. So Mr. Xu had been, his most memorable experience would be to be invited on the stage of the Spring Festival. It was a big performance every year for Chinese, and it's hosted at the CCTV Stadium. And he was invited three times, 2019, 11, and 20. Apart from the three times where he actually stood there and sang his song, there's 10 other songs that he produced were sung by other singers across all these decades. So he's an overachiever in that sense.
I love that so much. And by the way, my dogs are so excited that you're here, so you can hear her barking. So I apologize, but I hope you can still hear me. I'm also wondering, of all the songs that you wrote, are there any in particular that stand out?
里面有狗叫声。
对，他很抱歉，他说他的，因为你在这里，他的狗可能也很兴奋了，想要宣传。他的狗可能是我的粉丝。Yes, he said your dog might be she's fans as well. 他想最后想知道 你有没有哪一首歌是自己非常喜欢，愿意拿出来与我们分享一下？
我在除了在像春节晚会这样的舞台，这种国家型的大的舞台演出之外呢，我还非常喜欢到我们中国的少数民族的地区，就山里面啊，一些山寨里面，因为中国是很多少数民族的嘛。我现此时此刻就是在云南啊，中国的云南省啊，云南有很多少数民族，所以我在这里跟很多各个民族的兄弟姐妹们在一起，学习到很多少数民族的音乐的元素。因此我也创作了很多跟少数民族音乐相关的一些风格的作品啊，那把民族的元素和流行音乐的元素结合在一起啊。那有一首歌叫人走茶不凉，我不知道你应该怎么翻译。
好，这首歌是您最喜欢的是吗？
也谈不上最喜欢吧，就是我觉得是比较有特色的一首歌啊，我也希望能够通过这样的机会能够推荐给全世界的朋友们吧。
然后您说这歌是受哪一个民族文化影响比较大？
这首歌里面用到了五个民族的元素。哈尼族，彝族，拉祜族，佤族和傣族。
佤族，
佤族，
不，
佤族，
佤族 ，OK，
对，
傣族 ，OK， so right now, well, first, that's a great question because he's in fact not in his hometown. He's in Yunnan province.And like we talked about last time, there's so many ethnic minorities in that province. It's bordering Tibet, and some parts of it is on the Han Plateau. And he's learning the music culture that belongs to the local people. And he created this song called Ren Zou Cha Bu Liang. Anyway, I'm sure there will be a better translation than mine. And it combines the music elements from five different ethnic groups, Hani, Yi, La Hu, Wa, and Dai. So I told you before, there's 55 ethnic minorities in China. And then this song alone has five of them, the five elements, five kind of elements. And he really wants to use a Phoenix platform to kind of...influence people and to educate people about these beauties that's hidden in the remote mountains.
That's amazing. And I was just about to say, and my dog is still very excited that you're here, so my apologies for that. But I am, she's a big fan of yours already. And I'm so excited that you're also joining Phoenix because it is not only going to allow, obviously, you to spread your music, but I'm just so excited about the millions of fans and potential collaborators that you are going to be able to connect with through Phoenix. And I believe that great music, all great music is transcendent. And I definitely know that is what you're about. And I'm so grateful for your time today. And also my dogs here in New York City, thank you as well.
非常感谢今天接受采访，然后他的狗也非常的感谢你，然后他希望菲尼音乐也很开心能加入菲尼音乐，然后不光是与粉丝互动，也能与艺术家之间进行沟通，把中国少数民族音乐带给更多的人。
对，我也觉得这是特别好的一个机会和一个平台吧。能够让全世界的各国的音乐人音乐家一起有机会来交流，那我作为中国的一个音乐人我特别希望能够通过我的努力能够把中国的形形色色的各种色彩的音乐能够让大家听到那像我现在刚才有讲到我在云南那可能接下来我会有很多的时间精力会放在把中国的少数民族的音乐能够让 流行化，能够让更多的人听到喜欢啊，我会做这样的一个工作。那包括像我之前我的很多的音乐都是充满了我们中国的色彩的啊，那比如说像我有一首歌叫嫦娥，你知道吗？
嗯，
中国的一个神话，在月亮上，月亮上的一个仙女叫嫦娥。嗯，那这首歌也是曾经登上过这个春节晚会的舞台的，很好听的一首歌。我唱几句给威尔导演听一下。
He's going to show one of his favorite pieces.
Please, I can't wait. Thank you so much.
天边那轮圆圆的月啊，为了谁而圆？是谁为了与谁相见？啊，挂着不敢老去的容颜，心中这轮弯弯的月啊，为了谁而弯？谁揉碎了谁的思念？啊，抖落凡尘到人间。你是神话里的嫦娥，只能在梦里与你相见。举起杯，曾经把酒当歌，对着你天亮前说晚安。你是神话里的嫦娥，不知何日能与你相伴。你是否听见我的祝愿？祝愿月圆人圆，天地共团圆。祝愿月圆人圆，天地共团圆。
So beautiful. Wow. Well, thank you so, so much for that beautiful treat. My dogs are,
thank you.
My dogs are barking in the other room.
神话故事叫嫦娥奔月。
It's about the moon goddess, Chang'e, in the Chinese legend where she left her lover and she went to the moon. Well, actually, no, I think I got the legend wrong, but yeah.
I love it. It's such a beautiful transcendent song, and I'm so grateful that you shared your talent with all of us today. Thank you so much, and I can't wait to speak with you soon.
The digital age, artists and bands struggle to make a living. In fact, only a small number of artists can live off their craft. For the 98% of artists that don't have the luxury of being signed to a label, it's tough. But artists deserve to live off their art.Wherever you are around the world, appreciation of music does not change. FENIX brings bands and their fans together, whilst allowing bands to properly monetize their passion. The FENIX app will directly connect bands and fans with no need for middlemen. We're utilizing the blockchain to give the power back to the artist once and for all.Join FENIX, join the change.